Facts about the U.S. solar eclipse on August 21. On Monday, August 21, 2017, a total solar eclipse will be visible in totality within a band across the entire contiguous United States. It will only be visible in other countries as a partial eclipse. A solar eclipse occurs when the moon passes between Earth and the sun, thereby totally or partly obscuring the image of the sun for a viewer on Earth. A total solar eclipse occurs when the moon's apparent diameter is larger than the sun's, blocking all direct sunlight, turning day into darkness. Totality occurs in a narrow path across Earth's surface, with the partial solar eclipse visible over a surrounding region thousands of kilometers wide. The last time a total solar eclipse was visible across the entire contiguous United States was during the June 8, 1918 eclipse, and not since the February 1979 eclipse has a total eclipse been visible from anywhere in the mainland United States. The path of totality will touch 14 states and 16% of the area of the United States. The event will begin on the Oregon coast as a partial eclipse at 9:06 a.m. PDT on August 21, and will end later that day as a partial eclipse along the South Carolina coast at about 4:06 p.m. There are expected to be logistical issues with the influx of visitors, especially for smaller communities. There have also been issues with counterfeit eclipse glasses being sold. Future total solar eclipses will cross the United States in April 2024 12 states and August 2045 10 states, and annular solar eclipses, meaning the apparent size of the moon is smaller than that of the sun, will occur in October 2023 9 states and June 2048 9 states. 9 Facts about the U.S. total solar eclipse of August 21, 2017. The total solar eclipse of August 21, 2017 will be visible from a narrow path spanning the U.S. from the west coast to the east coast. Here are all the facts you need to know about this once-in-a-lifetime event. First total solar eclipse in 38 years. Solar eclipse in 38 years for those in contiguous United States. The last time anyone in mainland U.S. saw a total eclipse of the sun was on February 26, 1979. If you live in the U.S. and miss this event, you'll have to wait 7 more years, until April 8, 2024, to see a total solar eclipse from a location in the contiguous United States. Most North Americans will be able to see totality if they are willing to drive, that is. The total eclipse will only be visible along the moon's central shadow, which at its widest will be about 115 kilometers, according to some sources. Its path will span from the country's west coast to the east coast. The rest of North America, as well as Central America and northern parts of South America, will experience a partial solar eclipse. NASA has estimated that a majority of the American population lives less than a 2-day drive away from the path of totality, a once-in-a-lifetime event. While total solar eclipses are not rare, they occur twice every 3 years on average and can be seen from some part of the Earth. A total eclipse of the sun that can be seen from the American West Coast to the American East Coast occurs less frequently. In fact, the last time a total solar eclipse was visible from coast to coast was almost 100 years ago, on June 8, 1918. What makes this eclipse extra special is that it is the first time since the total solar eclipse of January 11, 1880. That a total solar eclipse will occur exclusively over the continental United States. No other country will see totality, though many countries will see a partial eclipse of the sun. Because of these reasons, The eclipse is also being called the Great American Eclipse. Parts of 14 American states will go dark. Parts of 14 American states will go dark for the 2 minutes of totality. The Yakina Head Lighthouse in Newport, Oregon will be the first location on continental U.S. soil to see totality. The partial phase of the eclipse will begin here at 9:04 a.m. local time. Lincoln City, Oregon will also be one of the first locations in the country to experience totality. Oregonians will also be the first to see totality as the moon's shadow moves east at an average speed of about 3,600 km per hour. After Oregon, the eclipse will move through Idaho, Wyoming, Nebraska, Kansas, Missouri, Illinois, Kentucky, Tennessee, North Carolina, Georgia, and South Carolina. Montana and Iowa are the only states where the path of totality will pass through unpopulated areas. People in Charleston, South Carolina will be some of the last people in the U.S. to see totality. Totality will be spectacular. If you are lucky enough to be in the path of totality, you are in for an astronomical treat, weather permitting, of course. When the eclipse begins, at first contact, it will appear as if the moon is taking a bite out of the sun. As the eclipse progresses, the sky will get darker, the temperature will drop, and if you pay attention, animals and birds will become quieter. At second contact, which is when totality begins, Bailey's beads become visible. As the moon completely covers the sun's surface, the diamond ring can be seen. You might also see pink spots called prominences near the diamond. These spots are caused by gases on the sun's surface. Totality is the only time when one can see the corona, the sun's atmosphere. At third contact, Bailey's beads will once again become visible and a second diamond ring may appear. Stars during the daytime. As the sky turns dark, planets and stars hidden in the sky by the sun's bright light will reappear. Look for Mars, Mercury, Jupiter, and Venus during totality. You will need eye protection. Do not look directly at the sun, before, during or after the eclipse without any protective eyewear. Looking at the sun with your naked eyes is highly dangerous and can even cause blindness. The safest way to see a solar eclipse is to wear protective eclipse glasses or use a pinhole projector you can easily make yourself. Part of SAROS Series 145. Solar eclipses occur in cycles. The SAROS cycle, one of the most studied eclipse cycles, occurs every 18 years. Two solar eclipses separated by a SAROS cycle have similar features. They occur at the same lunar node, with the moon roughly at the same distance from the Earth. The eclipses also take place at about the same time of the year and around the same time of day. Eclipses that are separated by a SAROS cycle are part of a SAROS series. The August 21, 2017 total solar eclipse belongs to SAROS Series 145. It is the 22nd eclipse in a series of 77 eclipses. The series began with a partial solar eclipse visible from the northern hemisphere on January 4, 1639 and will end with a partial solar eclipse visible from the southern hemisphere on April 17, 3009. The next eclipse in the series, a total solar eclipse, will take place on September 2, 2035. 2 weeks before, partial lunar eclipse. A solar eclipse always takes place about 2 weeks before or after a lunar eclipse. 2 weeks before the August 21, 2017 total solar eclipse, on August 7/8, 2017. A partial lunar eclipse will be visible from parts of South and East Asia, Europe, Africa, and Australia. Fun facts about the August 21, 2017 total solar eclipse. Adapted from posts by Michael Bakich, Astronomy Magazine. This will be the first total solar eclipse in the continental U.S. in 38 years. The last one occurred February 26, 1979. For most of Greater St. Louis area. The last total solar eclipse was in 1442. Totality crosses only through the U.S., no other country. It has been coined the Great American Eclipse. Everyone in the continental U.S. will see at least a partial eclipse. This eclipse will be the most viewed live ever. More than 500 million people in the U.S. Canada and Mexico will have opportunity to see a partial eclipse. The path where the sun is totally eclipsed runs through Oregon, Idaho, Wyoming, Kansas, Missouri, Illinois, Kentucky, and North and South Carolina. More than 10 million people are in the path of totality and 28 million people live within 60 miles of the path. The path will cut across Missouri from St. Joseph in the west to St. Genevieve in the east. 57 of Missouri's 105 largest cities lie in the path of totality. More than 3 million Missourians live in this path. 24 of Missouri's 53 largest colleges and universities are in the path with a student population of more than 130,000 students. Some of the eastern Missouri towns and cities in the path include DeSoto, Farmington, Festus, Herman, Hillsborough, Pacific, Thurrayville, Boadicea, Sweet, Genevieve, St. Clair, Sullivan, Warrenton, Washington, Union, and large areas of St. Charles and St. Louis counties. A spot near Carbondale, Illinois will experience the longest duration of totality, more than 2 minutes and 40 seconds. Missouri will experience as much as 3 hours of the partial eclipse and 2 minutes 30 seconds of totality. State capitals in the path: Salem, Oregon; Jefferson City, Missouri; Nashville, Tennessee; and Columbia. It is never safe to look at the sun without proper eye protection. The only safe way to view a partial or annular eclipse is using a projection of the sun. Filtered views of the sun can be safe too, but the equipment must be properly filtered and correctly used. During the time the moon's disk covers that of the sun, it's safe to look at the eclipse. In fact, to experience the awesomeness of the event, you must look at the sun without a filter during totality. You won't need a telescope. One of the great things about the total phase of a solar eclipse is that it looks best to naked eyes. The sight of the corona surrounding the moon's black disk in a darkened sky is unforgettable. You may experience strange things. Apparent nightfall, dusk to dawn lights may come on. Shadows will look eerie. Breezes may vanish and birds may come in to roost. A 10 degrees to 15 degrees Fahrenheit drop in temperature is not unusual. Total eclipse viewing events. Oregon. Corvallis. The Corvallis campus of Oregon State University will host a SU-150 Space Grant Festival, a total eclipse experience, a weekend-long celebration of the eclipse. A watch party will also be hosted on campus the day of the eclipse. Kaiser. The Salem Kaiser Volcanoes, a Class A baseball team, will play a morning game that will feature the first ever eclipse delay in baseball history. Madras. The city will sponsor a 4-day solar fest at 2 locations. Prineville. Symbiosis Gathering will be hosting a global eclipse gathering dubbed Oregon Eclipse. Salem. The Oregon Museum of Science and Industry will host an event at the Oregon State Fairgrounds. Idaho. The independent bookstore Rediscovered Books in Boise, Idaho, touts the 2017 solar eclipse in a retail example of science outreach. Craters of the Moon. The National Monument and Preserve will host NASA presentations, evening star parties hosted by the Idaho Falls Astronomical Society, high altitude balloon launches by the USC Astronautical Engineering Department and NASA, and presentations by the New Mexico chapter of the Charlie Bates Solar Astronomy Project. Idaho Falls free entertainment and educational seminars and an eclipse watching event at the Museum of Idaho, an official NASA viewing site and elsewhere, and a free eclipse watching event at Melaleuca Field. Rexburg Brigham Young University Idaho will offer a series of eclipse-related educational events. Wiser, the city will sponsor a five-day festival prior to the eclipse. Wyoming. CASPR, the Astronomical League, an alliance of amateur astronomy clubs, will hold its annual AstroCon conference, and there will be other public events, called Wyoming Eclipse Festival 2017. Nebraska. Alliance Entertainment and Educational Seminars will be offered. Auburn-Nemaha County Hospital will host an eclipse viewing event, including sharing safety tips from Lifetime Vision Center. The event is sponsored by Auburn State Theater. Grand Island Stir Museum will host an eclipse viewing event, including the launch of a NASA eclipse observing balloon. Beatrice Homestead National Monument of America, events with NASA Saturday, Sunday and the day of the eclipse Homestead events page. Missouri. Kansas City, a 5-mile bicycle ride from downtown KCMO to McKinn Park in North Kansas City has been organized by KC Pedal Party Club, a local meetup group. Lathrop, the city will celebrate its 150th anniversary with an eclipse festival. Parkville Total Eclipse Off the Park August 20th educational program featuring NASA Glenn Research Center Hall of Famer Lynn Bone Durant, 61, and August 21st watch party. Organized by Park University. An event organized by the St. Clair City Chamber of Commerce. An event organized by Front Page Science will be held at Rosecrans Memorial Airport, Illinois. Carbondale, the area is calling itself the Eclipse Crossroads of America since it will also be in totality during the solar eclipse of April 8, 2024, and since Giant City State Park, just south of the city, will experience the longest period of totality during the eclipse. Southern Illinois University will sponsor many eclipse-related educational events, including the two-day Crossroads Astronomy, Science, and Technology Expo, and viewing at Saluki Stadium. Amtrak will run a special train, the Eclipse Express, from Chicago to Carbondale. Carterville, a three-day rock festival called Moonstock will be headlined by Ozzy Osbourne, who will perform during the eclipse. Gorville, view the eclipse with the University of Illinois Astronomy Department. Kansas. Atchison Benedictine College will host thousands in its football stadium. There will be students from schools from Kansas, Missouri, Nebraska and Oklahoma attending, plus numerous other guests who will hear from, amongst others, astronomers from the Vatican Observatory. Kentucky. Bowling Green Western Kentucky University will host thousands of K-12 students in its football stadium. Hopkinsville, a four-day eclipse festival will be held at Jefferson Davis State Historic Site. Tennessee. Clarksville, Austin Peay State University will present several educational events, including an appearance by astronaut Rhea Seddon. Cookeville, Tennessee Technological University will be hosting a solar eclipse viewing party at Tucker Stadium, which is open to the public. Cookeville will be hosting special events Saturday to Monday. Minville, celebrating the eclipse by hosting Blackout 2017, an eclipse viewing event to be held in the city square. In addition to the viewing, a selection of food trucks and musical acts, which features the Pink Floyd Appreciation Society band, who will be performing Pink Floyd's The Dark Side of the Moon in its entirety. Prior to the Totality event, Nashville offering many special events, including the Music City Eclipse Science and Technology Festival at the Adventure Science Center. The Italian Lights Festival is hosting the largest eclipse viewing party in Nashville, a free NASA-certified eclipse event held at the Bicentennial Mall. Two astrophysicists from NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory will emcee the countdown. North Carolina Bryson City Planetarium shows will be offered, as well as rides on the Great Smoky Mountains Railroad to an eclipse location. Rossman Pisgah Astronomical Research Institute will be hosting a viewing event. The event at PERI has garnered international attention, and the visitors will include amateur astronomers. Georgia Blairsville Get Off the Grid Festival. South Carolina Columbia. The South Carolina State Museum will host 4 days of educational events, including an appearance by Apollo 16 astronaut Charles Duke. Greenville viewing at Furman University. Events include streaming coverage from NASA, educational activities, and live music. However, given the special nature of the eclipse, we can realistically expect these numbers to be higher. And when it comes to productivity, the eclipse isn't a good thing. A report by executive coaching firm Challenger, Gray, and Christmas Incorporated suggests that the solar eclipse could cost employers around $694 million, with states and metro areas falling directly into the path of the eclipse, taking the biggest hit at around $200 million in lost productivity. Whether you travel to see the eclipse in person or you decide to stay at home and gather around a nearby TV or computer screen to watch it, I hope you have a great time.